This video exclusive is brought to you by Richer Image, located at the Westwood Mall in Marquette. Richer Image offers studio, outdoor, and on-location photography for weddings, seniors, families, and more. Please call 273-0480 to set up an appointment or visit Richer Image at the Westwood Mall.
Thank all of you very much for coming this morning, early in the morning. We're here today to really announce some very exciting news with regard to the cause to eventually have Bishop Frederick Baraga declared a saint. Bishop Baraga, I think, as you all realize, was the very first bishop of the Diocese of Marquette in this long string of bishops here all the way down to me here as the current 11th successor to Bishop Baraga. And what we have to announce today is that we believe that we have a miracle, a medical miracle, that we can attribute to the intercession of Bishop Frederick Baraga. Later on, I'll ask Father Brown to give more detail about what that all means, but this is a very significant moment in the process that is in place already to eventually have Bishop Frederick Baraga beatified, called a blessed, and beyond that, we hope one day canonized and to be able to be declared a saint of the Church. I want to give just a little bit of background to how we get to where we are today and to try to emphasize the significance of this moment in the cause. The cause for Bishop Baraga was opened in 1952. So since 1952, there was an association, the Bishop Baraga Association, and we have representation here from the Bishop Baraga Association as well. Father Ben Paris is the current executive director of the association, and Elizabeth Deline is the editor of the Bishop Baraga Bulletin, and we all know that Elizabeth is the one that really runs the day-to-day operations of the Bishop Baraga Association. The association was founded in 1930, and so since then, there has been a lot of interest in the life of Bishop Baraga and in promoting knowledge of his life and his work, and interest in opening a cause for his eventual beatification and canonization.
Over to pray. The parish priest at that time bought a stole, which is a piece of vestment that a priest we wear when we're celebrating a sacrament. The stole was the stole from one of the stoles from Bishop Baraga. Bishop Baraga had worn when he celebrated sacraments. And so this was brought over. They prayed over the lady. They laid the stole on her abdomen region. And she experienced at that time a cessation. And she has testified, the person has testified, that at that point, knew that everything would be fine, that there was a healing. When they went into the exploratory surgery, no indication at all of any tumor, of any growth, of any problem at all. As a matter of fact, they found a completely healthy liver and all organs in that area completely healthy. They did just to be fully exploratory, they did take some samples of the liver to test if there was any cancer cells. There's no signs of any cancer, no signs of any growth. The surgeon could not explain this. The radiologist could not explain this because even had the surgeon invited the radiologist who had read the scans to come in during the surgery and to bring in the all the reports and to...
This is just a very exciting moment. And I think especially, I have to mention our Native American population. Bishop Baraga came to the upper Great Lakes region specifically to minister and to bring the gospel to the Native Americans living here. He had a great love for those he called his children. And his heart was always with the Native people. So I think this is especially beautiful moment for our Native American population in the Upper Peninsula to see the man who came to bring the good news to them, who loved them so much, potentially honored in such a way in the church. So we're just all very, very excited.